Okay, so I am doing the last video for the Windows Security class, IS3340. I've already clicked on the VLAB section. So here are the instructions that you can download. They'll download as a PDF, just like this. Or they may download to your downloads folder, just kind of depending. Once you look them over, let's go ahead and start our assessment. Pay attention to the submission requirements. Also, just in case you didn't download them, the steps are right here. These are the instructions for accessing the VLABs. And when you are ready, go ahead and click on Access VLABs. This resource does take some time to prep. For me, it takes anywhere between 5 to 10 minutes. So again, just kind of be patient with it. I'm going to go ahead and pause so that you guys don't have to wait. If you get this message, all that means is as you load your lab environment, it's actually loading three machines, the one that we connect to, plus two target machines. If you get this, just be patient. It will eventually fully load, and this screen will disappear. So again, just be patient. Okay, so part one says, let's go ahead and open up our target Windows machine. So we're going to go to RDP. We're going to open up our target Windows 1 machine. Once it loads up, we're going to go ahead and close everything. Okay. So once everything is closed and whatnot, we're going to go ahead and we're going to search for Microsoft Baseline Security Analyzer. Oh, helps if I spell Microsoft correctly. Microsoft. Oh, and I did it again. M-I-C-R-O. Can't forget the O for micro. So once we've gotten here, we're going to go ahead and click on Scan a Computer. We're going to make sure that we are doing security updates. However, in our lab environment, we're not going to do that. In real life production, we would be doing it. We have to remove it there because we don't have any direct internet access with this machine. And when we are ready, click on Start Scan. We know it's going to find errors with the security. That's why it was powered off. And the first thing, it doesn't take a whole lot to learn, or a whole lot to populate, but... Sorry. It does not take a whole lot of time to run. Once it's done running, the population is pretty quick. And then you can see the issues. You can see the ones that may be an error. You can see the ones that are caution. And you can see which ones are good by the green check mark. Okay, this lab environment does not... There it goes. Luckily, there's no red X's, so we don't have any major problems. So now let's see here for updates. Let's see what was scanned. This will show why it was throwing an error. There's also, how do I correct this? That way you can see kind of what was scanned, why it was flagged. And how to correct this is not, there we go, just kind of going really slow. It will show you the steps or the possible solutions to correct it. Password expiration. That's the one that I clicked on to actually populate it. That'll explain the issue, why it was an issue. Things like it could be past its maximum age, it needs to be changed, all of that good stuff. But that will give you a general idea of how to fix it. Okay, so the instructions are to do it for auto updates, password expiration, and incomplete updates. Come up with a plan to implement. Implement it, rescan. That way we can see that the vulnerability analyzer will actually show that those issues have been fixed. And that's actually it for this machine right here. This is a Server 2012 machine. So now let's do it again. Let's do it on a Windows 2008 machine. In 2012, the baseline analyzer is already installed for us. 2008, it may not be. On these machines, it already is. So we're going to navigate to it. All programs. Microsoft Baseline Security Analyzer. It's already been installed for us. We're going to do the same tasks. Scan a computer. We're going to uncheck security updates. Start our scan. Notice this one takes a little bit longer to scan. So, general same things, but can we update them? Like, can we save them? We can actually copy to clipboard. So once it copies the clipboard, we're actually going to paste it. We're going to create a new rich text document. Not just a regular text document, but a rich text document. Name it student. Target. Windows 2 scan. And paste what we copied. And that should come directly from our baseline analyzer. Go ahead and save it. And again, correct updates, correct the expired password, and rerun the scan. That's actually it for this lab. It wanted to show that you can take an issue, like an expired password, see that it's throwing an error, then do corrective action so that you can fix it. Don't forget about part 3, the challenging questions. That's going to ask things about where things are, or items are saved and whatnot. But that's actually the essence of this lab. Go ahead and close out of everything. Do not forget to submit all of the required documents. And thank you. Have a great day.